Hello students, how are you? Again you are welcome to the online class of Montessori School. Myself Nazneen, your EVS ma'am, and I am your EVS teacher, and I am taking your EVS class in class 4. So today students, again in this class we will continue to our chapter number 4. Okay, so you take out your EVS book and take pencil in your hand. Today we will do our next topic. So now let's start. So in previous class we have discussed up to here. Now in today's class we will start from the types of houses. So in houses in rural areas. Rural areas means the village, jise gaon kehte hain. Okay. So in village, what type of house you have seen in village? The house, what you tell? The house which is made up of straw or which is made up of mud. I hope that these types of houses you have seen in the village. So that types of house is called the kacha house. Okay, see here. This is the kacha house made up of straw. Okay, so now let's start our topic, houses in rural areas. Most of the houses in the villages or rural areas are made up of kacha materials like mud, straw and dried leaves. So most of the houses in the village made up of mud, straw and dried leaves. Such houses are known as kacha houses or huts. So these houses are known as kacha houses or huts. These houses are not very strong and these houses are also not very strong. But nowadays with changing times, the houses in village are also being made, come to next page, by using materials which are strong like brick, cement, wood, concrete, iron, etc. So as the days are going on, the times are changing, so the houses in village are also being made by using materials like bricks, cement, wood, concrete, iron, etc. Okay, houses in urban areas where we are living. We are living in urban areas, that is the city. Okay, so in cities, which type of houses you have seen? The bungalows, the houses made up of bricks, cement. Okay, so these types of houses you have seen in the urban areas or your surroundings. Okay, this is also the bungalows which you have seen in the cities or in the urban areas. Okay, so these types of houses are known as pakka houses, and these houses is also the strong house. Okay, houses in urban areas are stronger and more durable than those in rural areas. So houses in urban areas are stronger and more durable than those in rural areas. These are called pakka houses, and these houses is called the pakka houses. Pakka houses are made up of bricks, cement, iron, wood, etc. Some houses have many rooms like drawing rooms, dining rooms, kitchen, bathroom, bedrooms, etc. So in urban areas, in the houses means the people which are making their house have many rooms such as drawing rooms, dining rooms, kitchen, bathroom, bedrooms, etc. Okay, independent houses with gardens or lawns are called bungalows. So independent houses with gardens or lawns are called bungalows. So you have seen in bungalows that inside, means beside the bungalows, gardens and lawns are there. Okay, where there are buildings each with many houses called flats or apartments, and from there many houses are there, that is called the flats or apartments. Okay, so now come to houses according to the climate, means the houses which is according to the climatic condition. So in cold regions, ओके, इग्लूज आर टेम्पररी होम्स ऑफ एस्किमोस. दे आर मेड अप ऑफ ब्लॉक्स ऑफ स्नो एंड दे प्रोवाइड शेल्टर अगेंस्ट आइजी कोल्ड स्किन. सो इन कोल्ड रीजन्स दिस टाइप्स ऑफ हाउसेज यू हैव सीन. यू नो दिस, वट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस हाउस? दिस इज द इग्लूज. ओके, आर टेम्पररी हाउस ऑफ एस्किमोस वेयर द एस्किमोस आर living. They are made up of blocks of snow and these are made of blocks of snow and they provide shelter against icy cold wind and they provide shelter against the cold icy cold wind. So in today's class, keep up to here only. Tomorrow again we will continue to our next topic. Okay, now your today's homework is read chapter 4 up to Todd. Thank you. Goodbye.